Hello all, I'm Amin. I'm gonna share with you some of the architectural patterns that we used on our campus that they helped us to cultivate a culture of innovation and entrepreneurship in our ecosystem. So the ecology of innovation and entrepreneurship is a very complex one. It includes all these different components that are displayed on the screen. So how do you start talking about this ecology in terms of place and space? That's where the concept of pattern comes in. So patterns are meaningful constellations that relate some of these components to one another. This presentation in particular is about six architectural patterns that we used at the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee. They're best practices, and I'm going to share them with you. The first one is this diagram. It says that if you need right places in your community, you need to have right people cultivating right processes, curating right processes, managing right processes on your campus or your community. For instance, at the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee, we have four cohorts of university innovation fellows, almost 20 people. There are multiple faculty. They run hackathons, they run courses, they run workshops, and they all happen in multiple locations on campus. The second pattern, though, is mostly geared toward the first pattern. It says that you need to have multiple scales of the same pattern. So it's the same diagram that is being repeated in multiple sizes, small, medium, and large. You need to have recreate your place, small, medium, and large. You need to have group sizes of medium, small, and large. So for instance, we're going to have a very fancy Center for Entrepreneurship and Innovation on our campus, but doesn't mean that we're going to give away all the nooks and crannies that we have planted on our campus throughout the years. The third one talks about strategies and ways that you can that help you attract people to your place. They're magnets. Anchors are the ones that keep them in the place, and triangulators are the ones that help people to relate to one another and to interact with another. So for instance, we usually use art in order to attract people to our location. We provide people with a variety of places to sit and even food to eat so that they can anchor, and we run a lot of different activities for them to relate one another and to interact with each other. The fourth one is about increasing your contact area with your audience. It's more about relating to people who are not as committed in the mission of innovation entrepreneurship as you are. It's called peripheral participation. The way that we do it, we use place as a showcase. We use it as a display board to display the things that we're using and the things that we're producing, the processes that are being unfolded in our community. And this is an example of one of the places that we have. The fifth one starts with this assumption, with recognizing that people have different ways of collaborating with one another. So they have different ways of engaging with each other and engaging with different things or people or artifacts in your community. For instance, lean forward type of engagement is associated with high activity and thinking. Lean back type of engagement is associated with what you guys are doing with listening and criticizing. Laid back type of engagement is a typical day in Wisconsin. People drink and have fun and recharge. And the last one is creating a rhythm for your community. And we do it using space. Rhythm, in fact, is an indicator of the aliveness of the community. We try to distribute our entrepreneurial efforts spatially all over the city. We try to occupy the city, occupying social spaces, occupying coffee shops, campuses, colleges, high schools. And with that, we keep all of our efforts exciting, and we keep ourselves excited. So the challenge that I leave you with is, how do you use patterns of architecture, patterns of place, to cultivate a culture of innovation entrepreneurship on your campus or your community? Okay. Thank you.